Oh yes, everyone. Very happy to meet you all back, right? Fine, everyone. So let us begin our understanding today. Yes. So today we are going to learn about your plant tissue culture. Yes, everyone. Very good evening. Come on. So yes, Shilpi. Yes, Aradhana. All right, Poonam, Mayank. Yes, Gunjan. All right, yeah, Chanda, come on everyone. So very happy to meet you all back, right? Yes, very good evening one and all. So now we are going to learn about your plant tissue culture, right? Okay, yes, that's fine, right? So this is about me. I am Dr. Saranya. I have already completed my PhD in biomaterials, and this is my profile, and you can check out my publications in the ResearchGate profile, and this is my ORCID ID. Great, okay. So today, as I said, we are going to look into your plant tissue culture, right? So yesterday, what did we learn? Yesterday, we learned about your animal tissue culture, isn't it? Right. So today, we are going to learn about plant tissue culture. Relatively, plant tissue cultures are quite simple and easy when compared to your animal, right? Because plant cells, you know, they are little bit comfortable with this. Animal cells are very, very sensitive, so you need CO2 and all that things. But plants, they are too much compatible with this. All right. Yes, everyone. So while learning with your plant tissue culture, this is question prone also. I will show you there are many questions from your CSER net. Yes, from this plant tissue culture. All right, fine. So two major things are ruling your plant tissue culture. Number one, it is called as this totipotency. All right. So what is this totipotency? Totipotency is, it is the inherent ability for generating the whole plant. Yes. So that is what is called as totipotency. The whole plant it can regenerate. Yes. And what is the next term? It is called as your plasticity. What do you mean by plasticity? Yes, plastic. And why do you call them as plastic? You can change, as per your need, you can mold them accordingly, right? So plasticity, it is going to be the ability of your plants to alter their metabolism. You can alter the metabolism, you can alter the growth and development, right? Such that it is going to suit your environment. So this is what is called as your plasticity. Right. So these two terms are now clear. What is going to be your totipotency? What is going to be your plasticity? Yes, everyone. Yes, Priya, Vijay Durga, Anushka, Sumaya, Umarani, Pranab and Pooja. Very happy. Come on, everyone. So this is what it is your key terms. So that is involved with your plant tissue culture. Right. So all these plant tissue culture things, yes, so how do they begin to grow? Yes, so they begin their growth. Yes, oh yes, yeah, Praneet, very happy. So they are going to begin their growth by means of the fragments. Yes, so what is that fragments? That fragment that you make a cut from the mother plant. Okay, so that cut portion, okay, that little bit fragment, it is what is called as your explant. Okay, so what is mean by your explant? Yeah, Praneet Reddy, come on. Yes, Shilpi. Yes, Gunjan. Yes, Anishka. Poonam. Come on, everyone. Yeah, so that cut portion is what? Yeah, Pushpanjali, very good afternoon. So that cut part is what is called as your explant. All right. So, can you state some example of your explant? So, it may be a leaf, it may be the stem, it may be your root, yes, it may be your embryo even, right? Yes, Anita, come on. So, all these things are being called, as your explant, right? So, any fragment, right, absolutely, yeah, Shilpi. So, this explant, initially, it is from your mother plant, it is a fragment. Now, you are putting this explant into a culture. Yes, Amandeep, very good evening. Yeah, Shilpi, pollen is there. Yeah, Sumaya, seed is there. So all of them, they are called as your explant, any part of your plant. Yes. So, but remember, the plant should be living. Okay. Right. So that should be from your living plant. Right. It should not be a dead one. Rather, it should be a living plant. Right. So now your explant will be selected, right? And then you can initiate the growth by two ways. Number one, you can grow them, right? You can initiate the formation of the shoot and the root by planning with your media, okay? So your media is going to help you to initiate your root and shoot, right? Or else you might go by this somatic embryogenesis method. So this is another important method. We'll be seeing everything in detail, don't worry. Right? So two major methods, whether it is going to be your root and shoot organogenesis, or you might go based on your somatic embryogenesis. Right? So now you have obtained your explant, you are going to culture them. Right? So you are going to put them into the media. Okay? Yes. Before this, you have to sterilize them. Why not? Yes, Poonam. So if you are not sterilizing it, what will happen? Your explant may contain all your microbes, right? So that might happily grow in your culture media. So that is why you have to sterilize them. So you have to sterilize the explant. Yes, you can use by wiping with your ethanol. You can do any kind of surface sterilization. Apart from that, all the media that you use, you must be sterilized. Yes, so all the items that you are using, all your tongs, you know, knife, everything must be subjected to sterilization. All right. So what do you do? You take up your explant, right? And then you put them in your appropriate media. Probably, no, you use the MS media. This is the most commonly constructed media for your thing, right? So once you put them, this explant is going to undergo a process called as your de-differentiation, right? Actually, your explant, it is well-differentiated tissue, right? From that well-differentiated form, it is undergoing a process called as your de-differentiation. Once it is de-differentiated, it is going to form your callus, right? So what is this callus? MS, it stands for Muracigi and Scoop media. All right. Yeah, it is a media that is used in general for growing up your plant tissue cultures. Right. So then it will be forming the callus. After the callus, there is going to be your re-differentiation. Right? And then you are going to subculture and regenerate them. Right? Yeah. I am going to show it, Pranay. Don't worry. So after your regeneration is done, you are going to harden the plants and then finally you will transmit them to the greenhouse. All right. Oh, yes. So like if you take your plant tissue culture, you have different variety of methods. Right? So you are going to use your seeds, embryo, all your cell or callus, pollen, organ, protoplasm, meristem. Everything you can know, you can just make it out. All right. So you were just asking about the components of your MS media. Right. So your MS media or your Muracigi Scoop media, it is going to contain your nitrogen, potassium, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, iron. Right. Yes, Ratna, I will tell you. Right. Manganese, cobalt, copper, zinc and molybdenum. So all these are your components of your MS media. So I have mentioned the functions also. So nitrogen, it is what it is making up, your nucleic acid and all, right? And then your potassium, it is going to regulate your osmotic potential. And calcium, it is required for your cell wall, right? And then your magnesium, it is a cofactor. Phosphorus, it is what it is, making your nucleic acid and all, right? So likewise, everything is important. So what is going to be the de-differentiation? Okay, see here. For example, you are taking a leaf, okay? So this leaf is an explant. So what is the nature of the leaf? Yes? Your leaf? what is the nature? It is arising from your shoot. Right? Okay. Now you have damaged the leaf or you have excised the leaf and you have put them into the media. Okay. So what it is going that. Huh? No, Anishka. You just have an overall idea. Okay. Maybe sometimes you might get a match the following. Right? So you might get the match the following. So just have a total idea of which is which. It is going to match off it. All right. Yes. Absolutely. Yeah. So your leaf is meristematic in nature. And if you put them into the media, it is going to de-differentiate. De-differentiate means it is getting back its totipotent nature. Got it? Yeah. So it is going to get the totipotent nature. That is why if you can play around with your auxin and cytokinin ratio and you can generate a root out of this explant, you can generate a shoot out of this explant. So this becomes your re-differentiated form. Yes. So now these two definitions are clear. What is de-differentiation and what is re-differentiation? All right. Oh yes, Ratna. I think your doubt is now done. Yes. So what is re and what is de-differentiation? All right. Fine. So now let us use all these terms still more better. Right. Your explant. It is the excised piece. Right. And it is going to be anything. And what is your callus? Callus, a key word is, it is an undifferentiated mass. Okay. So your callus is undifferentiated. Okay. So that is capable of rising to anything else. So that is why this is called as it is having a totipotency. Right. De-differentiation means from mature cell, it is becoming back to your meristematic cell. Yes, remember in your plant cell, the stem cells are nothing but your meristematic. Yes. Yeah. So, from your mature cell, it is becoming a meristematic cell. So, that is what is called as de-differentiation. And what is de-differentiation? From callus, that is in undifferentiated form, it is come back to the differentiated form. So, this is what is called as the re-differentiation. All right. Yes, everyone. I think this is all clear. All right. So, you can do your callus culture. You can do your suspension. Majorly, your protoplasts, they are grown in your suspension cultures. Right. And then you do have your cell culture, single cell, single cell proteins, spirulina. All right. Shoot and root culture, embryo culture, meristem, anther. No, all these are the different things that is being used. All right. Yes. No. Callus is undifferentiated. Okay, see here. Your callus is unorganized and undifferentiated mass. Okay. Yes, your callus is always undifferentiated. But that can undergo de-differentiation to form your next kind of cells. Right? Got it? Yeah? All right. Fine. Yes, absolutely. So this undifferentiated, it is having your totipotency, right? Yeah. Yes. Redifferentiation means absolutely from your de-differentiated, it is becoming differentiated, right? So that is what is called as your redifferentiation. Yes. Clear? Oh, yes. That's good. Yes, Pranit Kumar. Yes, Ratna Umarani. So this is clear. Yes. Very good. That's great. Right. So these are all the different type of cultures you have. And if you take off with your single cell culture, yes, you have your Bergman's plating technique. Okay. Yes. So here you take your cells in a suspension. Okay. So it is used for your suspension, especially your protoplast. Then you mix them with the media. And then you might plate them, right? Apart from the direct plating, you can use your filter paper method. So this is called as your rafting. So you perform a raft. Yeah. So generally, who is helping in the shoot culture? Remember that. Shoot, who is promoting the shoot? it is going to be your cytokines and auxins, right? So like you use your NAA, right? So your shoot and root cultures, they are controlled by your auxin and cytokine imbalance. Okay, so if your auxin is more, remember AR, okay, right? Oh yes, yeah, Chandini, December batch, we will begin with July, don't worry, right? But what I can tell you is that you can start learning from now. Okay, so you will have all these recorded versions. By that you can slowly start reading the old ones, because the syllabus is same for you, right? So I know the recorded versions are available from April. I did a revision course, so that will be of more worth if you start from now only, because the speed I take up, maybe you will take little more time to complete that old ones. So if you are already started to prepare it, if you have time, you can start taking notes from the recorded version. It will be easy for you once the batch begins. You can pick up with our speed, right? Because you do have a lot of units to read, right? So don't wait for a batch. You can begin by now only, because always your recorded versions are available and the live doubts you can get cleared, right? Oh yes. Yes, Anushka, raft. What do you mean by raft? Raft is nothing but you have a filter paper, okay, and then underneath you have your nurse. What do you mean by nurse? See, all the nutrients you cannot give into the media. So what you do, you keep the same thing you can use in your animal culture also. So you grow your mother cell or the cell that is going to contain the nutrients below, over which you place a filter paper. Above that you make your culture. Now what happens, through this filter paper all the nutrients will be passed into your cells, right? So this is what is called as your filter paper raft method, or this is called as your nurse tissue culture method. Okay, yes, so this nurse cells will give all the nutrients. Okay, so this filter paper, it will be wetted by this tissues, right? So it will derive all the nutrition from the callus, right? So from the callus it can very easily grow up. So that is the concept behind your raft thing. All right. Oh yes, Pranit Kumar, you can visit our you can download our Unacademy app, right? So once you download, there is an option called subscription, right? So you click on into the subscription and you can go for 1 year subscription, and then you can use my code Saranya Live. So that is going to tell right, so that is going to give you a 10% off on the fee, right? And then you click the subscribe button, then you can access to all the 13 units, along with that the party, and you can attend the classes of all the educators. Actually, students who are preparing for the GATE, they can make use of the chemistry sessions also, because for GATE you need chemistry, right? So all those things, it is going to get covered in this one roof subscription. All right, fine. So I will tell you in detail also, don't worry. Right, okay. So coming back here, these cells, it will be plated on the filter paper. So they will obtain the nutrition from the callus. Right, everyone? This is clear? Right. So if you take your root culture, yes, you need more of your auxin. Right. If you want a shoot culture, yes, then what you should use? Yes, yes. What do you use for shoot? Opposite, root is auxin, so shoot is cytokinin, isn't it? See here, you use increased amount of auxin to make up a root, right? Yeah, yes, yes. So cytokine, you use it for the shoot. Okay, yes. So if you use excess of auxin, you are going to use a root culture, and if it is going to be excess of cytokinin, that is going to be a shoot culture. I think very recently we had a question. Yes, so if I want a hairy root culture, yes, 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 definitely. So if it is going to be a hairy root culture, right, it is a mutant of a gene. So it is a mutant of which gene? I have a hairy root culture. Okay, right. So it is mutant of which gene? Yes, yeah, Pranay, come on. So hairy root cultures, that means only root is there. So oxygen or auxin is fine. So it is a mutant of your cytokinin. Got it? Right. So if I grow only shoot, so that is a mutant of your auxin. Got it? Because auxin is meant for root. So if it is mutated, then your root cannot grow. So it becomes a shoot. Right? Likewise, if cytokine is mutated, right, then it cannot grow the shoot. So that becomes a hairy root. Got it now? I think this was your December question. Alright, so this is all clear? Good, good, fine. So the next one, it is your somatic embryo. So remember, for somatic embryo, you need 2-4-D. Auxin for root, cytokinin, it is for shoot. Right, and then your somatic embryo, it is going to be your 2-4-D. All right, yes, yes. Likewise, you do have your meristematic cultures. Yes, and these meristematic culture, you use your cytokinin. Right, so meristematic culture, you use your cytokinin. All right, yes. And then, you know, for your embryo culture, yes, the embryos, they are obtained from, yeah, Poonam. So this embryo, it is obtained, you know, from, for your nutrient media, and they are obtained from your developing seeds, right? So it is helpful for, yeah, it is a hormone. 2,4-D, it is a hormone that is helpful for your growth. All right. Likewise, you do have your ovule culture. Yeah, it is a hormone. Your 2,4-D, it is going to be your 2,4-dihydroxy, you know, this thing. I'll just give you your total abbreviation, don't worry. Alright, so it is the most commonly used, you know, hormone for your growth. Alright, it is your dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Alright, yeah, so that is a very commonly used phenoxyacetic acid, dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. And that is, yes, absolutely, Anushka. You are absolutely correct. Yes, Chandini, definitely I will upload more videos. Alright, so coming to that, it is a synthetic auxin. So that is meant for your embryos. Alright, so next it is going to be your ovule culture. Right, so these are all your different organ culture. This you could have done in your lab. What is this? Synthetic seed. So for synthetic seed, what do you use? Remember this? All right, so synthetic seed, which one do you use? You use your sodium alginate, yes, and then your calcium chloride. All right, so your sodium alginate and calcium chloride, it is going to couple and it is going to form your sodium chloride and then calcium alginate. This calcium alginate, it is going to be a polymer, right? And it is going to get immobilized and your seeds are now safe, right? So they are protected from this environment. Yeah, these are the beads. How do you form this bead? Due to the polymerization. Okay, so due to the polymerization, yeah, so now you are going to form the beads using the needle. You could have done it in your lab. All right, fine. So let us take a couple of questions. Yes, so many questions every time it is coming from your CCR net. Yeah, so let us solve a couple of questions. Right, number one, auxin, and then your protoplast culture. Cytokinin, microspore culture. Yes, so what is going to be the correct one? Yes, auxin. Yes, so what is the example of auxin? Yes, very good. IAA, indole acetic acid. It is the best example, right? Yeah. So what are the other commonly used auxins apart from your IAA, right? So what are the other auxins, that you use up apart from your IAA? Yes. Which other auxins you commonly use up for your thing? Yes. So you have five basic things, isn't it? So your indole acetic acid, and then you have your indole butyric acid, All right, and then you have your indole propionic acid, right? And then you have your naphthalene acetic acid, right? And then you have your 2,4-D. All right, yes. So all these are coming under your auxins, right? So this is clear. So auxins, they are helpful in which culture? Auxins, they are helpful in your root culture. Yes, everyone, absolutely. Yeah, so absolutely, no, this A is going to be 4, right? So by that only you can find out that is the answer, right? 4 marks for such a simple question. All right, yes, very good, very good. So apart from that, so what is your protoplast? So protoplast you have to remove, right? Yes, absolutely. So you protoplast, you have to remove them, right? Yes, then you use your pectinase and cellulase. All right, cytokinin, what about your cytokinin? Your furfural aminopurine. All right, and then your microspore culture, it is going to be your embryogenesis. So the correct answer is your option B. Very good. So let us make a move into the next question. So it was an attempt to increase the yield of your commercially important enzyme from a natural isolate. Okay, so several strategies were adopted. Number one, the genome was modified such that you increase the yield. Okay, and then you just change over the culture requirement such that you can increase the yield, or else you induce the mutant and you screen, no, which is better synthesizing your levels, or it was modified so that it can produce a better enzyme. Yes, which is better? So you can modify your genome, you can change the culture requirement, you can induce the mutant, or you can modify them. Which could be the correct answer? Yes, why not B? I mean, why not A also? Yeah, everything you can change. You can modify your genome such that you increase the yield. You can reappraisal your culture requirements. You can induce the mutant. Everything is going to be correct. A, B, C, D, all are correct. All right. Yes. Fine. So the following statements. Yeah. So the following statements are related to your plant tissue culture. Number one, your frabile callus. It provides the inoculum. All right, so your callus is providing this inoculum to form your cell suspension culture. This process is known as your habituation. So what is habituation? It refers to the property of callus that is losing the requirement of your auxin and cytokinin during your long-term culture. Or this cellulase and pectinase are used for generating your protoplast, right? And during your somatic embryo development, torpedo stage, it is formed before your heart shape, right? So which is correct? Think and tell me. Yes, Mayank. Options, sorry. Other two are hiding, so I will give you the option C. All right, yeah. Just I'll give you some ABD. ABD is already there. So A and B. So this is going to be ABCD. Yeah, Shweta. All right. Yes. Good. Fine. So yeah, Pragati. Yeah, Chandini. Oh, thanks a lot, Chandini. Right. So the correct statement or correct thing, it is going to be your option A. Why? Yes, Anishka. Yes, Gunjan. See here, your torpedo stage cannot come before your heart stage, isn't it? So if you check out the stages of your embryo, first it is going to be the heart, and finally, it is going to be your torpedo. Right? So this is absolutely wrong. D is gone. So only option is your AB. Yeah, Kaushik. Yeah, Musani. Very good. Yes, Anushka. Happy for you all. Come on, guys. So let us make the next one. So remember, for protoplast you use your cellulase and pectinase. I think this is repeating in many questions, isn't it? All right, just make a note of it. All right, fine everyone. Frabile means it is very porous, and it is it is having the ability to get separated. All right. Oh, thanks a lot everyone. Come on. Good. Right. So the next question, protoplast fusion. Yes. So habituation, see, if you take your callus, it is made to get adapted. Okay. So that adaptation is what is called as your habituation. Okay. Right. So it is losing the requirement for your auxin and cytokinin during your long term culture. Why? Because the callus itself, it has all this ability. All right. Fine. Okay. So coming back here, your protoplast fusion, it is used in your plant tissue culture that can be used for various applications. Right. So in your protoplast fusion, your naked plants are used, or it is helping in transfer of organelles is not possible. Partial genome transfer is involved. Your cells from two different plants can be mixed and fused. So which is going to be the correct one? Yes. Yes. Which is going to be the correct one? Yes, Anshu? All right. So think of your protoplast, you remove the cell wall, right? So it is a naked plant cell, true or false? Statement by statement. So this is true. So one should be there. So this option is gone, right? Yeah, fine. Next, transfer of organelles, yes, is not possible. Is it so? You do a protoplastic fusion, right? So definitely this transfer of organelles is possible, right? So this is wrong. Partial genome can be formed, right? And fusion is, protoplasmic fusion is very famous, right? Yeah. So definitely 1, 3 and 4 is going to be the correct answer. Got it, guys? Very good. Come on. And yes. And this is an application question. Yes. So find who is a mismatch. 4 marks. Right. So codeine. Oh yes. Yes, Gunjan. See, every year one question has come. See here, almost every year you can check out your question number 138. See here, 1 year this is 139, another year. So 14 marks is for sure from your plant tissue culture. Can you see it? So every year you get at least one question in this number 136, right? So definitely 4 marks is for sure from your plant tissue culture. Got it? Yes, Gunjan. Very good. Come on. Right. So which one of the following is a mismatch? Right. Yes. So codeine, papaver, vinblastine. All right. So vinblastine, Cathartes roseus, quinine, chinchona. So you remember all those things, right? Who is mismatch? This digitalin, is it with your this Artemisia? Do you think so? Definitely not. So this is the mismatch. Quinine and chinchona, it is correct. Yes. And hydroxyquinine, it has become a buzzword now, isn't it? All right. Vinblastine, it is definitely from Cathartes roseus, cancer treatment. Codeine, papaver, definitely, right? So the mismatch is digitalin. Got it? All right. Oh yes, everyone, we are at the end of the class, right? Okay, so all the very best, and if you are planning for December, start your preparation by now only. Don't wait for the batch. Why? Because seriously, there is a lot to study. See, you have to finish at least 8 units, okay? So now only it is your June half, right? Your exam will come in December middle. So now only you have only 6 months. That means within 1 month you have to complete, make notes, right, of at least 1.25 units, such that you will get time for revision. All right. Oh yes, yes, Anshu. I have a special class by 8 p.m. That is also a free session at An Academy. So you can definitely visit our An Academy platform and register for the special class at 8 p.m. today. I am dealing a very important concept tonight. So that is going to be on your lac operon, tripoperon, and arabinose operon. All these three are very important for your exams. So don't miss out tonight 8 p.m. class at An Academy. It is a free session. You can download the PDF also after the session. Alright, so if you are planning for December, this should be your speed, like in 1 month. Yeah, Anisha, today only. Yeah, yeah. Oh, Pragati, very happy for you. Right, right. So, no, this is seriously very important. So, don't make a rush at the end, right? From the first only, start preparing note. Yes, yes. Yeah, 8 p.m. I'll meet you tonight in An Academy platform. Alright, fine, fine. Their interaction will be very easy because here in YouTube, after you type, then you have to, wait, because the streaming will be little bit slow. There you will get very direct interaction. Yes, how to register it? First, you create a login using your mobile number. So you will get an OTP to go into the login. Once you have logged in, you just visit the CZR net homepage. Under that, it is very easy only. Yeah, so under that, yes, you can visit your Google Play Store. Okay, in Google Play Store, you can just type as An Academy Learner app. Okay, so you click this An Academy Learner app, you can download this app. Once you have downloaded, oh Chandani, that's right, I have students from Dubai, I have students from Singapore, everyone, they are, once they come back, they will be taking up these exams. Good to know, Chandani, very happy for you. Right, so you just download the Google Play Store and then you download your An Academy Learner app and select the CZR net. Under that, you can find my name, Saranya. If you are not able to find, just search my name as Saranya CZR net. Right, there you will have a category called as the special classes. Okay, so just click that class and click this enroll button. Okay, so then by free you can enroll with this lecture. After the class you can download the PDF also. This will be very helpful for you. All right, fine. So if you want to subscribe, right, definitely you can do that, because this 1 year subscription, it is going to give you an all in all one package. So you will have the access to all the 13 units. Part A, Varghi sir is taking, Christy sir is taking. And then we are going to give you your unit test, week test, mock test and all. And then we have your doubt clearance session. And all this you get at 11,500. After that, 10% off by using my code Saranya Live, right? After that, you download An Academy app, you will have some credits. Okay, so you can redeem the credits for another 10%. So total you will get 20% off. So this is coming around only 9,200 for 1 year. Okay, so don't miss out this opportunity, right? So enroll at the earliest and start learning, right? Okay guys, I will meet you shortly in my session. Bye bye, take care, stay connected. Seriously, time is running. It will not wait for anybody. All right. Oh, yes, Amarani. Thanks a lot. All right. Okay, guys. Meet you soon. Bye-bye. Yes, yes.